Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to install MSP-OSD on an OpenIPC camera. So basically what that does is it enables the original, the native BetaFlight OSD to be able to run in any OpenIPC camera, including the RunCam, the Mario all-in-one, the ultrasight, and the DIY camera. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is that we have to log into the camera. And we need to modify a file that that is related to the telemetry. Okay, I hope you can see it now. It's the USR pin telemetry. We will delete these two lines. These lines are for the mapping telemetry. We're not going to use mapping telemetry anymore. We are going to use MSP from DisplayPort. Okay, and we should remove the map link from here and add the MSP OSD. And now we need to download and upload to the camera the file. So this is the developer of the MSP OSD. His nickname is Tipo Man, and all credits go to him. And the binary file is in the release. This one. We need this binary file. I have already downloaded it, and the fonts. And in order to upload them, you type this command. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the fonts. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and also the font HD. One font is for the 720p, and the other one is for 1080p. And we need to give some executable rights to this mod. MSP OSD, and we reboot. So after the reboot, you can see that we have all the OSD printed on the video stream, but we need to set it up correctly through the BetaFlight now. Click calibrate ports. I have reset my BetaFlight, so everything is on default. So I can show you how to set it up, and you go to the UART that you have connected the telemetry and enable it with enable the MSP display port. Save and reboot. sure that you want to make sure that the OSD is enabled. And if we go to the OSD, there is a bug at the moment that you need many widgets to be on the OSD in order to work. This will be fixed in future releases, of course. But for now, let's just to demonstrate what is that is actually working. Let's put the battery voltage here on this side. You see, it doesn't update, it doesn't do anything until I enable some more complicated widgets like the artificial horizon. It needs more data to be able to keep the link alive. So if I enable those two, you see that I immediately have widgets and BetaFlight obviously working. And you can see that if I move the flight controller, it is working fine. Okay, and that's it. Thank you very much for watching.